गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास सेवन. आई एम अनिल भगत, योर साइंस टीचर फ्रॉम मॉडर्न इंटरनेशनल स्कूल हिसुआ. वेलकम बैक टू आवर ई लर्निंग प्रोग्राम. टुडे इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट चैप्टर 11, दैट इज ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इन एनिमल्स एंड प्लांट्स. And today we'll discuss about the topic called transpiration. In the last video lecture, we had discussed about how plants absorb the water and the mineral nutrients by the help of their root hairs. And these root hairs increase the surface area for the absorption of water and mineral nutrients from the soil. And after absorbing this water and mineral nutrients from the soil, by the help of vascular tissues, that is xylem and phloem, here for the transfer of water and mineral nutrients, xylem help and it will transfer the water to the different parts of the plant. And in the leaves, food is prepared by the process of photosynthesis. And after the preparation of food, this food is transferred to the different parts of the plant by the help of the tissue called phloem. So here, this is the role of xylem and phloem. Then we discuss that this xylem will form a tube-like connected channels through which this water will pass from roots to the leaves. Now today we will discuss about transpiration. In class 6 you already learned that plants release a lot of water into the in the form of water vapor by the process of transpiration. And we all know that plants absorb water and mineral nutrients from the soil, but the water absorbed by the plant, the whole amount of water is not used by the plant. So this excess amount of water is removed by the process of transpiration. That is, this excess amount of water will be released by the stomata which are present on the downside of the leaf, that is the lower side of the leaf. And from there, these stomata, these very small tiny kidney shaped holes are there. From that, this excess amount of water will convert it into water vapor and released into the atmosphere. And this process is a continuous process. So due to this process of transpiration, there will be a force will be come into action. And this force is called suction pull. This force is called suction pull. Means here, this because of this process of transpiration, there is a force will created which will try to suck the water from the roots or the ground. And because of this pressure, water will reach to the leaves. So in this way, transpiration is also helpful for the transport of water and mineral nutrients to the different parts of the leaves. Now here is the thing that in our regular life, we can take the example of a pipe, and there if there is a gallon of water and we want to transfer the water into another vessels, then what we use? We use a small pipe and put the pipe into the gallon, and by the help of our mouth, that is the air pressure of our lungs, we suck the water from the gallon, and the water comes out from the pipe, and then we put the pipe into the vessel, the other small one, and the water from the gallon will transfer into the small vessel. And here this suction force from our mouth, it will make the water from the gallon to come to the tube and from the tube to the vessel. So this way transpiration also helps the plants to take water from the ground and take it to the leaves, and from there excess amount of water will be removed by the process of transpiration. So class, I hope you are able to understand about the process of transpiration and how transpiration is helpful in the process of suction of water and mineral nutrients from the ground. So class, if you have any problem, ask me, I will help you. Have a great day. Be safe at home. Thank you.